I'm with Lorice Abufarha from Helping Hands. Now, Lorice, what is Helping Hands?
We are a small group, volunteers group, to help the people with skin disease, genetic skin disease, it's called EB. We give them bandages, medicine to help them to live without pain.
Now, the skin disease is called epidermolysis bullosa. Are there many people here in the land that have this disease?
We have more than 40 people, 40 children and adults in whole Palestine.
When was this group of people put together?
It's before maybe 15 years, when Tinica from Holland, she adopted a girl with this disease, and she know everything about it. She asked Caritas Hospital, when they have the same disease, to let her know, and she will help.
What is this disease? What happens to the children with this disease?
It looks like a burning skin. We give them the medicine of burning, and we give them medicine for the health, because they bleed every day.
There's no cure for this disease. They live with it constantly.
Yes, they live with it.
Yeah.
Because no way to heal.
So you're working with disabled children with this deformity and skin problem. Are these children wanted by their parents?
Some of them. Because the parents, they didn't know about this disease. They didn't know what to do when they have child with this illness. So we went to their houses with Caritas Hospital, a nurse from there, to let them know how to clean, how to put the bandages, the medicine, how to deal about. Some of them, they accept the children. Some of them, they have many children before, so it's very hard to spend 2 hours every day to change.
Do they wear bandages every day?
It should be. But if they haven't bandages all the time, so they do it every week. So that's very sad.
So this must be very, very expensive for a family to be putting bandages on their children.
Yes, of course. Yeah, yeah, it's very expensive. So we help whatever we can do.
Is this disease a very painful disease for the child as well?
Yes, it's painful. If you leave it, if you didn't clean it every day, it's very painful.
Do many of these children get rejected and sent away?
Until now, no. We help them to stay at home with their parents. We didn't have a place, special place for them. We help them in their houses.
What do these children need practically for their life?
They need bandages, they need medicine, they need, some of them they need insure, because also in their mouth there is a bleeding and something like this. So yes, we give them if we can.
What is life like for a child with this disease?
It's not easy for them. You know, they stay home, most of them they stay home because no school for them. They are intelligent. If their parents can give them homeschooling, is okay, but most of them, they can't do it.
Do some of them go to school?
Some of them, they go to school because we have steps in this disease. If they can walk, yes, they go to school, but most of them, they can't, so they stay home.
Are they accepted with other children within the school?
Not all of them. Honestly, not all of them.
Yeah. As they get older, can they go on to live a more normal life?
No, the same. Yeah. The same, yeah.
So they know that this is going to be for the rest of their life and very difficult.
Yes, they know, yeah.
So it must be very difficult having a child with this sort of disability. Is there support out there, apart from you? Is there support for the families?
Some of them, yeah, they can buy. Some of them, they can't, really. We know the families. We visit their houses, and we know if they need more than some families. We put a package every 2 months, whatever we have, you know, we send to them.
And this takes the burden off the family, doesn't it? Do these children suffer a lot from rejection within the community?
Yes, yeah. many of the normal people, they didn't like to touch them, to talk to them, to be with them at schools because they bleed, you know.
Now, Christmas is coming very soon. What are you planning to do this Christmas?
Yeah, every Christmas we do a party for them, and they wait for this party every year. This year we want to do it. We want to give them a special cake, present little bit, and a box of bandages and cream.
Mm-hmm. Do they come from the Bethlehem area or further afield?
No, from everywhere. Mm. They came from Ramallah, from Hebron, from Bethlehem to this party.
How important is it for them to come to celebrate Christmas here?
Yeah, they like to celebrate with us, yeah.
Do they like to sing the Christmas carols and the Christmas songs?
We have this year Mr. O.K. He's a clown, and he do a story from the Bible about love, about many things, and they enjoy it. He's very good actor.
Are they all Muslim children? Are they Muslim children, Christian children, a bit of both?
No, they all Muslims.
So this is a good opportunity to bless someone of a different faith.
Yes.
Does bringing these children together with the same disability help them to see that there are other people just like them?
Yes, of course. Yeah. They are now friends. They talk together. They want to know what's the best for their children. Many mothers, they say, I give them this medicine and this medicine, and you know.
So it's like a network of helping.
Yes, yeah. Like to collect them in the same place.
Yeah. You're going to give them Christmas presents this year as well?
Yes. I hope we can do the best for them.
Why do you do this work?
I like them. Yeah, I like to do this. I like to volunteer with these people, especially these people.
Yeah.
They are very cute. Now I am in Facebook, in Messenger with them. They talk to me. If they need anything and I have it, I send it to them. I give taxi to go to Ramallah with the materials to help them.
What's your prayer for these children particularly?
In the beginning, I hope every day they have their medicine. Then I pray to people expect them. Not, you know, sometimes we saw them, nobody want to talk to them, nobody want to touch them. We pray for these people. We pray for the parents, to give the power for parents. You know, it's not easy. Every day, 2 hours, the mom spent 2 hours cleaning this child. It's really not easy for them.
It's a real dedication and devotion, isn't it?
Yes.
Do you go into their homes and visit them in their homes within the community?
Yes, we visit at their homes, but we prefer to collect them. In Hebrew, we collect them in a place. They know they came to this place every time we want to give them like funny day, you know. We sometimes clown came without taking any money from us. They become very happy. So yeah, we decide to do this every three, four months.
Now at your Christmas party, is Father Christmas coming?
Yes. There is a volunteer says, just give me the dress and I will come.
Yeah. And they'll be so excited, won't they?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Okay, Lorice, thank you much.
Welcome, Paul.